Ignition sequence starts. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Hey everybody, this is the Digital Asset Investor, and I am at World CryptoCon in Las Vegas, Nevada. This is a trip that I had planned before Swell, before I ever received a Swell invitation. And so yes, I am now in a position to where I have to fly to Swell, fly to come out to Vegas, and then immediately turn around and fly to Singapore in order to make Swell. But I have learned in life, folks, that sometimes you just got to man up. And the digital asset investor plans to man up for sure. Now, since I have been here in Vegas, I've literally walked around and nobody knows who I am. They haven't seen who I am. And I have walked up and talked to many people that you've seen me cover on this channel. And it's a very funny thing to watch them try to figure out who I am. It's been kind of funny. Yesterday I met Charles Hoskinson was an example, the guy that started Cardano. And I actually showed his tag here in this video. But it's been a pretty interesting experience so far. I just decided a few months ago that at some point it was going to be time for me to start just getting out there. And so last night I tweeted this out, and that is, and sorry if my voice is a little weird from my experience, that when you come to Las Vegas, I don't know if it's the altitude or how it's dry out here or what, but it affects your voice in the way and takes a little while. I'm really messed up on the sleep. I literally got up this morning to put this video together, and I did it because I couldn't sleep. It was like 3 or 4 in the morning in Las Vegas because my biological clock's all messed up. So tweeted this out, and I did tweet this out last night. 6 p.m. Eastern Time Tuesday, first ever live stream featuring Mr. B, Brad Combs, Cryptopolis, the official neighbor of the Digital Asset Investor channel, Dustin Plantholt, who is one of the guys doing the documentary, and then the Digital Asset Investor with the photo reveal, hashtag zero doubt. So that will be happening at 6 p.m. Eastern Time, and I sat down. This is, you'll find this funny, as all of you know that listen to me, I sat down with Brad Combs last night, and I said, you know that this is a technically challenged channel. Well, I sat down with Brad Combs last night, and I said, no, Brad, the only reason I haven't told anyone that I'm willing to do a live stream is because I don't know how to set up a live stream. Can you tell? Help me set up a live stream. And so Brad agreed that he would help me. So it will either be done on my computer, or if we have a hard time with that, I'll just do it using my phone. We shall see. So away we go. And then of course next week is going to be Swell. Okay. You'll notice here, I didn't know he had put it here. The official neighbor of the Digital Asset Investor channel sent me this. Now, do you know how many times on this channel that I have told you, use the phrase, it's just a matter of time? Well, I've used the phrase, it's just a matter of time, when it comes to XRP on ATM machines. Well, that just a matter of time is now up. Misty Sins, who I believe lives here in Vegas, I've seen her do this before, at Sins Misty. For those of you that are in Las Vegas for crypto events, be sure to check out Crypto ATMs on Fremont Street, now listing XRP. Now, this is awesome right here. I blew up one of the photos that she said. So, as I said, folks, it was just a matter of time. And now you can get XRP. You can buy and sell XRP on an ATM machine. And as you might recall that a while back, there was a spring announcement, as I recall, where they were getting they were going to invest in an ATM company, and I don't know if this is the same company or not. Let me back away. See, I don't see what the name of the company on there is, but anyway, once I saw that, even though they weren't announcing at that time that XRP was going to be on the machines, I knew that the clock was ticking. Okay. Lord Lionel sent me this. And it's more ripple exposure. I actually watched this advertisement air on UK Sky TV's and TV's India channel Star Plus. Watch in the bottom right corner there, folks, because you are about to see what it's all about. Transfer Go runs on Ripple. I thought that it was over in this corner, but it was not. Runs on Ripple. So the commercials, who was it that told you that you would be wrapped in crypto advertising? That would be the digital asset investor. Okay. And it's just now beginning. I believe you'll see backed commercials pretty soon, especially when they're ready to hit the retail customer, which is what this is about. This is from Bond Crypt. Let me get some water here. This Vegas dry weather does a job on the throat. Back to launch. Consumer app in first half of 2020 will test product with Starbucks. Mike Blandina will be launching a consumer app to make it easy for consumers to discover and unlock the value of digital assets. And then I think I had another thing here from Chinu Patel. Let's see. Chinu Patel, this was from Mike Novogratz. Follow this space. Lay is a big deal. I don't know what that is. Crypto acceptance is coming. Backed to launch consumer app in the first half of 2020. We'll test product with Starbucks, the block. So now I hope that their plan is to try to test it using the XRP ledger, because if they try to test it, let me go ahead and tell you, I've told you before, back, if you try to test with Starbucks is going to give you the middle finger once they realize just how slow Bitcoin is, unless you're using the XRP ledger. And so, backed, go ahead and listen to the digital asset investor and learn before this becomes an embarrassing nightmare for you. XRP is the one and has always been the one. Okay. We have next XRP Crypto Wolf. XRP's daily transactions shatter 1.63 million and are about to make a new all-time high. The previous all-time high was 1.7 million during XRP's parabolic bull run, December 2017 to January 2018. XRP transactions accounted for more than half of all crypto transactions in the last 24 hours. Now, when I was just now, let me go to the next thing real quick. Just now, when I was talking to the official neighbor of the Digital Asset Investor channel, he told me XRP was to 31 cents, and I just realized I haven't even looked. So let's look. We are now at 30 cents for XRP. The total market cap is at 247 billion. I just have this feeling that things are about to start really happening. But we shall see. I'm going to go back to this because I saw this looks like it might be a pretty cool thumbnail for today. All right. Next to this, this is Ben Melnicki, excited to join Ripple as America's head of regulatory affairs. Look forward to working with policymakers and regulators to make an impact in the industry. I'm assuming this guy is a part of the new Washington, D.C. office. Now, I don't know if I've ever told you on this channel, I love Washington, D.C. There are two places in this world that I love. One is Las Vegas. Two is Washington, D.C. I just love walking around and just seeing the history of it. I also love London, England, which I plan to go to as well. I've been there two or three times. But this guy, welcome aboard, is what I say. Welcome to the revolution, Ben. And then Michelle Bond tweeted him out as well. It's great to welcome Ben Melnicki. Ben brings 15 plus years of regulatory policy and legal experience. We are thrilled to have him on board. And then Ripple hired a former Bank of America, this is XRP Crypto Wolf. Ripple hired a former Bank of America and former blockchain cryptocurrency wallet executive as their head of regulatory affairs for the United States. Ben Melnicki will work for policymakers, the SEC, and many regulators to make an impact for Ripple, XRP, blockchain, and the crypto space. So this is going to be interesting. Now, then Ripple put this out as they're starting to talk more about Swell. Swell by Ripple is just 10 short days away. Be sure to follow along at Ripple Insights during the show November 7th through 8th. For now, here's a peek at last year's event. You can see this video on their website from last year, but you see that Ripple's starting to talk about this. Okay, XRP Crypto Wolf. Custody bank State Street is looking at Bitcoin as the first iteration of the global digital asset and is also looking at certain cryptocurrency digital assets and securitized assets. State Street thinks that all assets will eventually be traded. And this State Street, remember, they manage like 10% of the world's wealth. These guys have started popping up a lot. And I think that they... Let's see, looking at Bitcoin as the first iteration of global digital asset. I think these guys are involved in custody of assets from what I recall. Don't quote me, but if they keep popping up in the news, it makes me think that maybe these guys are about to go all in on this. Wouldn't surprise me. Then Michael at VAL 5 Links, who is always hard at work for me, not for me, but in general, sent this. Now, folks, remember a few days ago, China announced that they are getting all in on digital assets. I'm seeing China after China. These guys are putting the pedal to the metal. Look at this. I found several things this morning about China. This is from Sid Vicious. He says, "Hey, CT, now that I have returned from my month-long trip to China to visit my wife's family for the first time, I wanted to share my experience from a crypto fundamental perspective. During my travels, I noticed everyone, including young and old, was using digital payments via QR scanners and mobile device transactions. It didn't matter whether you were in a big city area or countryside or way up in the mountains, payments were done electronically 95% of the time. China does use fiat, but the primary method is to use QR scanners. Even the cab rides require a QR scanner to get a ride depending on where you are. I spoke to my brother-in-law regarding the fiat or when they plan to remove it. He said in the next 2 to 3 years, but possibly sooner than that. Given the Bitcoin market cycle, that would put us right in line with the end of the second phase of bull cycle in 2022. Basically, the U.S. is way behind in this as we still use plastic and nowhere near what China can do, putting all pride aside. What I want you all to know is China will help bring mass adoption once the government gives the green light. The infrastructure is in place, and it would not take long for the people to use crypto seamlessly. I spoke to my wife about this, and there is no bureaucracy when it comes to president executing a decision. Upon my return to the U.S., I saw that Xi Jinping, this is what we talked about, making statements on this very thing. From a fundamental perspective, it is good that they are creating some sort of digital currency. Regardless, either way, it will cross-pollinate. I like that. Cross-pollinate with the standard. Just imagine how the Chinese will impact the total crypto market cap. I have bought Bitcoin and XRP I've brought up Bitcoin and XRP with the locals, and many of them do not know about it. But the ones who did are very deep into it and do most of the trading in Singapore since it's banned on the mainland. However, they mine Bitcoin like crazy, and not many know of XRP, but I know two guys who have just over 250,000 XRP each, and I was the first person to ask about it. They have other digital assets as well, Litecoin, ADA, Ethereum, EOS. I asked them why did they have XRP, and they said because of the IMF's actions, which is the very same reason I got into it. In my opinion, June, August 2020 is going to be a pivotal time in the crypto sphere from a fundamental and techno analysis perspective. Nothing is going to stop the fourth industrial revolution. Now, here's what I'll tell you about what Sid Vicious says here. My father told me the whole time that I was growing up is that money that is spent on traveling and getting out into the world and seeing what is really going on is money well spent. And so I have done a lot of traveling, and I will tell you firsthand, until you actually go places, you can't judge them and you can't really know what's really going on. And so that's why it's so important what he's saying here. This is coming. It's here. China is, and now I'm about to show you some of the things that are happening with regard to China, and you tell me if it's imminent, because that's what I believe we're talking about. XRP Trooper at Trooper XRP, from CZ Binance. Now this guy is world traveler. He's everywhere. When China moves, this is a tweet from him. When China moves, it moves fast. Considering it's the largest body of population on the planet, it's incredible. Don't get left behind. Embrace it. And he's showing you this China to launch digital currency, DCEP. According to this video, to be confirmed, their central bank will launch the digital currency called DCEP to be tested and onboarded with commercial banks first. And then there's this from Bond Crypt. My point all along. Other countries should pull their socks up once and for all and stop their petulant actions. China forward thinking. Chinese banks should immediately embrace blockchain, says top central bank official. And then there's this from Michelle Vandenberg. One of China's largest banks, Industrial and Commercial Bank of China, or ICBC, with a digital currency wallet. This is moving very, very fast. One of the unique characteristics of China is that it can be quite nimble in certain ways. And they're showing you this wallet, ICBC wallet. And then there's this, China's central, for Mr. Use Case, China's central banks are issuing their own sovereign cryptocurrency called DCEP. Wake up, people. Ripple is leading a new financial ecosystem and is poised to make XRP the blood of the system and will probably be worth a heck of a lot more than it is now. Look at this. This was back when Ripple welcomed the Chinese central bank to their headquarters, and then they were looking for a head of China operations. China is definitely of interest. It is definitely a target. Jeremy Light, vice president of European Union strategic accounts at Ripple. How many companies that are working on the primary use case for your digital asset even have a vice president of European Union strategic accounts? He told at CNBC in a phone interview, China is definitely a country and region of interest. You better believe it. All right. And then this is interesting. I was actually in this Litecoin summit yesterday. I didn't see John McAfee do this. It says, when official McAfee makes a joke and the host doesn't get it, host, time for questions from the audience. And John says, not unless they were screamed. Oh, host, okay, goodbye, John. And then I think John McAfee said, like, that had some little cussing rant that he didn't think they heard on there as well, which is always hilarious. Okay, and then there was this. See here, XRP Max a Trillion sent me this one, which is a John McAfee update. Are you represented in the Congress? Take a look. And so you got to go check that out, and I always have to make you aware of it. Then this is from Charles Hoskinson, who I met yesterday, and I did take a photo with him to be released at a certain point. Litecoin Summit 2019. He was there. I saw him. Let me tell you a quick, funny story. There was this guy, and I'll just give you his first name. His name was Patrick. Myself and many, and about three or four guys from the XRP community are standing around in a circle. Keep in mind, nobody knows here what I look like. Nobody's seen me. We're standing around in a circle, and this guy. His name's Patrick, and he's going on. He's an excited XRP community member, and I can tell you that he recognized Brad Combs, and Brad was sitting there talking to him. The conversation came up about who do you like, who do you like in the XRP community, and they said, do you like Alex Cobb? And he's like, yeah, I love Alex Cobb. Do you like so and so? They get to the digital asset investor. Do you like the digital asset investor? He says, oh yeah. He says, yeah, I hope I get to meet him one day. And just on a pure whim, I stuck my hand out to shake his hand. I said, well, then nice to meet you. If you could have seen the look on this guy's face, it made the last 2 years all worth it to me, because this guy could not believe what he was seeing. And I actually sat there and we all talked to him and we all laughed about it. And it's really, I knew that eventually the day would come that I would begin to go out there and go meet people. And so I just felt like I was ready to start doing that. And so away we go. And finally, and by the way, I did the same thing while you're all thinking, those of you that know who Bitcoin Ben is, I did the exact same thing to Bitcoin Ben. We all had him in a circle, and I've got some funny, I think we may even have some video, but I've got some funny moments. I've got a picture. I've got some funny moments where we're talking, I'm talking to Bitcoin Ben, but the way that it happened initially is we're talking to him. He did not recognize my voice. And he's the nicest guy in the world. He and Charles Hoskins and the Patrick guy, bitch, nicest guy in the world. But we're talking to Bitcoin Ben. He has no idea who I am. And all of a sudden, I just leaned into him and I said, I'm the digital asset investor. And he goes, no way. But we really did hit it off. He's a super nice guy. He's a bit Litecoin guy, Bitcoin guy. But he was very nice and a very good guy. And so we've had an interesting time just walking around and seeing what's going on. I always wanted to go to one of these crypto conferences, and so decided that I would go to this one and let it be the first one, because I love Vegas. And I had, but anyway, that's enough on that. Finally, I wanted to show you this. Lammy J sent me this. They are traveling in Liechtenstein, and he sent me this picture. And so I think I'm gonna use this as my thumbnail. Because he, right here, he put on the bottom here, he put this sticker. It's got a cup of cinnamon coffee. It says, see you in Liechtenstein. I'm a digital asset investor. I'm not an investment advisor. This is for entertainment purposes only. Please subscribe and hit the like button. And if you've ever told your friends and family anything, tell them that the digital asset investor and friends will be live doing the first live stream ever at 6 p.m. Eastern time today. Thank you for listening.